Hello friends, welcome to this session. In this session we learn this topic, failure of octet rule, or we can say limitation of octet rule. This octet rule was successful in explaining the valences of large number of elements, but it failed to explain many of the structure. It failed to explain that is atoms in this molecule, they have electrons in the valence shell either short of octet or more than octet, means in the valence shell they may contains more than 8 electrons or less than 8 electrons. So this was the basic limitation, or you can say failure of the octet rule. We'll see some examples to understand why there are some compounds which have octet, which have electrons in the valence shell less than 8, and which are having more than 8. First condition is incomplete octet, means those molecules, ions which have less than 8 electrons. For example, we can say hydrogen, lithium, beryllium, boron, aluminium. Aluminium sometimes you can say, but mostly lithium, beryllium, boron. So they are there forming electron deficient compounds because they make the, they have the valence shell which have less than 8 electrons. Or we can say group 1 and 2 and group 13. These are the basically elements. So they do not form the covalent bonds. Why? Because they have less than 4 electrons in the valence shell. For example, lithium chloride. So if you go lithium chloride, so in this Lewis dot structure, you can say lithium making 2 electrons. It is again duet bond is there. If you take beryllium chloride, so you can say it is taking 2 Cl by Lewis dot structure, but beryllium having how many electrons? 2 plus 2, 4 electrons in the outermost shell. So again less than 8 in BF3. So this is attached with a 3 fluorine, so there are 3 bonds. So we can say beryllium having here how many bonds? 3 bonds. Okay, so 3 bonds means how many beryllium is the electrons getting in the valence shell? So 2 plus 2 plus 6 electrons. So again, it is less than 8. So this is the incomplete octet. Now next is your expanded octet, or you can say formation of the super octet molecule. Super octet means more than 8 electrons. So this is formed by the PCl5, SF6, IF7. These are the molecules which form the super octet. So here we can see the PCl5. So phosphorus surrounded by the 5 chlorine, and they make the 5 bonds. 5 bond means how many electrons are present in the phosphorus around? So it is surrounding 10 electrons are present around the phosphorus. Similarly, if you take the SF6, in SF6 sulfur is surrounded by the 6 fluorine. So sulfur has 12 electrons in their valence shell. Similarly, IF7. So iodine having 7 bonds with the fluorine. 7 bonds means 7 into 2. So one bond carry 2 electrons, 7 into 2, 14 electrons. So this is the expanded octet, or you can say these are the super octet molecules. Next is the limitation is that there are some compounds of novel gases. So they also form the compounds, even the novel gas, because novel gas has the complete octet, like neon, argon. So helium is exception. It has 2 electrons, it's duet, therefore duet. But neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, so they should not have the ability to form the compound. But they are in some compounds like xenon and krypton, they form compounds with fluorine oxygen. So these compounds are basically xenon fluoride, F2, F4, F6, XeOF2, XeOF4, KrF4. So these are the compounds formed by xenon and krypton. Neon argon, they are not forming, but they are forming these compounds. Next limitation is that the octet rule is not able to predict energy changes during the bond formation. This is one also limitation, in which it is not predicting the change of energy. Next is your during the formation of molecules, they form the odd electron bonds. So this concept was given by Luder. How this stable molecules are forming the odd electron. What is the meaning of odd electron bond? First you have to understand. Odd electron molecules means double bonds are formed by sharing of an odd number of electrons. Sharing of an odd number of electrons. That is, electrons may be 1, 3, 5, etc. between the two bonded atoms. The bonds are called odd electrons. Means in one bond there may be 1 electron, 2 plus 1, 3 electron, 5 electron like this. So here octet rule is also violated. So these molecules are quite stable and parametric in nature. Let us see the examples of 1 electron bond. For example, H2 plus. So this is a 1 electron bond. You can take even helium 2 plus, you can see. Or we can say alkali metal molecules, they have the odd electron bonds. So H2 plus having a bond size 61 kilocalorie and H2 having bond 109. So these molecules are less stable than hydrogen. And their bond length, you can see, the bond length of H2 plus is 1.06 angstrom, while hydrogen is 0.74 angstrom. So this is the longer bond. So bond length is longer than hydrogen and bond energy is less than that of hydrogen. Even B2S, this is also a one electron bond molecule. So between boron and hydrogen, you can see boron is surrounded by the 3-3. So one boron, this part and this part, they're having the one electron bond between the molecules. Even we have alkali metal molecules have odd electron bonds, like Li2 plus, K2 plus, Na2 plus. So these are bonded by the one electron bond molecules. Now we'll see the examples of 3 electron bond molecules and ion. So these are examples: helium 2, 2 plus, oxygen 2, nitric oxide, nitrogen dioxide. So they are called as 3 electron bond molecules. They can mark, they forms the 3 electron in one bond. For example, helium 2 plus. If you see helium, so this is the helium 2 electron, this helium only 1 electron. So there will be the bond of 3 electron between 2 heliums. So this is the 3 electron bond molecules. Similarly, oxygen normally having a double bond, but by using a double bond, the property of the oxygen should be dimagnetic, but it failed to give the dimagnetic nature. It is actually the paramagnetic nature of molecules. So Pauli suggested that the bond between this oxygen should be double bond and 2 odd electron bond, means there will be 2-3 electron bond and one is the normal bond. So this is the example of double odd molecules. So it also confirms, this structure also confirms that oxygen is a paramagnetic molecule. Paramagnetic means they can easily attack in magnetic field. Yes, oxygen can be attacked by the magnets. Nitric oxide, so nitric oxide means you can see between nitrogen oxygen, so oxygen having 8 electrons, but nitrogen having how many electrons? So 3 plus 4, 7 plus 2, 9 electrons. Nitrogen having in valences. This is also violating the octet rule. See, 2 normal bond and 1 is the 3 electron bond. It can also give this type of structure also. If 1 electron shift here and 2 electrons shift this side, so you can this structure. And also if 1 electron will shift this side, then oxygen becomes odd electron molecule. So it can get 2 type of structures. Similarly, NO2. So NO2 having 1 bond is the 3 electron bond and 1 is the normal bond. It can also make a structure like this also. So if you shift this to this side, this one this side, so we will get the 2 type of structures. And NO2 also dimerized due to this odd electron molecule. So they can form the molecule N2O4 like this. So one molecule will attack the other molecule to form this. So they are normally dimerized, these type of molecules. Similarly, ClO2, this also odd electron molecules. So one having the 3 electron bond, one is the normal bond, one is the coordinate bond. This will also dimerize. Superoxides. Superoxide O2 negative cause superoxide. This is also forming the what? 3 electron bond molecule. So this is oxygen, and one is the 3 electron bond and one is the normal bond. So this superoxide, ClO2, nitric oxide, NO, O2, helium 2 plus, all these are 3 electron bond molecules. Now, what are the properties of this odd electron molecules? What are the properties? So, odd electron bonds are generally established either between two like atoms or between different atoms, which have not more than 0.5 difference in their electronegativities. So, this should be difference between the two atoms. It should be less than this, not more than this. Then there is a possibility of odd electron bonds. All electron bonds are approximately half as strong as a normal covalent bond. So they are half as strong. These molecules are extremely reactive and have tendency to dimerize. For example, NO2. So NO2 will dimerize like N2O4. So this is AB molecule. AB molecule are two odd electron molecules. So they will form after dimerization ABPA. Again, bond length of this one electron bond is greater than that of a normal covalent bond, whereas the bond length of a 3 electron bond is intermediate between those of a double and a triple bond. Next point, one electron bond is a resonance hybrid of a two structure. So this atom has one electron, so they can make resonance hybrid. What is a resonance hybrid? We will study in next lectures. You have to see this next lecture to understand what is resonance. So this is electron is having A, now this electron is having with B. Similarly for 3 electron bond, there are 3 electrons. So this A having 1 electron, B having 2 electron. Now in other resonance structure, A having 2 electron, B having 1 electron. So this is called resonance hybrid. Now we'll see why the deviation was occurred, why the octet rule was failed. So there are some rules like Sidgwick maximum covalence rules. He has given, he gave the rule of covalency, how the bond is formed between the atoms. So in many compounds, this octet rule fails when covalency is more than 4. This is the one condition, when covalence is more than 4, then octet rule is failed, like PCl5, SF6, IF7, that we have already seen. Generally, covalency of an atom is equal to the unpaired electron present in its outermost shell. I mean, the number of unpaired electron will decide the covalency of an atom, but this is not always true. For example, hydrogen having one unpaired electron, so covalency will be 1. For nitrogen having the 3 electron in the outermost shell, so covalency of nitrogen is 3. But covalency of nitrogen is not always 3, it can be 4 also. Even oxygen, there are 2 unpaired electrons, you can see 2p4 means there will be 2 unpaired electrons. So covalency should be 2, but oxygen shows the covalency of 3. Element present in 3 or higher periods contain a vacant d orbitals, and their excitations of ns or np electrons to nd orbitals, with electrons present in ns or np, they will excite to and it will go into the d orbitals, resulting in increase in the number of unpaired electrons. Therefore, this element having the more than covalency more than their unpaired electrons, and covalency increases. For example, PCl5. If you take the how many unpaired electrons present in phosphorus, there will be 3 electrons in the ground state. But due to the excitations, what happens? One electron from the s will jump and it will go into the d orbitals. So now the number of unpaired electrons will increase to 5. Similarly, it happens with the sulfur also. Sulfur having the 2 unpaired electrons, but two from the p, it will jump into the d, then it will give 6 unpaired electrons. So according to the Sidgwick rule of maximum covalency, so the maximum covalency of an atom, it depends upon the period containing the element, and it is equal to the total number of electron pairs which can be adjusted in valency shell. So generally, maximum covalence are shown by an element is equal to the total s and p electrons in its valence shell. For example, aluminium having the 6, silicon having the 6, phosphorus having the 5, sulfur having 6, iron having 6. This has the maximum covalency shown by the element. We can see they are also forming the compound also. So aluminium forming AlF6, silicon SiF6, PCl5, SF6. All these are the maximum covalency of these elements. Maximum possible covalence of a different period are given. So we can identify which element can make the maximum covalency. So these are the periods, this element and maximum covalency is period 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 1 means only hydrogen, helium. Helium cannot form covalency, hydrogen can form covalency maximum 2. So number of unshared electrons shared will be 4. Second period, if you take lithium to fluorine, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, they will make the maximum covalency 4 in this period. In this, I am not talking about lithium can take 2 covalency, boron can make 4 covalency, beryllium can make 2 covalency. So maximum covalency is, but in this second period, maximum covalency of the element will be 4, and number of electrons shared will be 4 into 2, 8. Third period, from sodium to chlorine, sodium magnesium to chlorine. So maximum covalency will be your 6, and number of electrons shared will be your 12. But chlorine is an exception, it can make the covalency 7 also. In the 4 and more than 4, So maximum covalency will be the 8 and number of electrons shared will be a 16. So it is not always necessary for an atom to show its maximum covalency. For example, iron, say iodine, it never shows the covalency 8, but maximum covalency is 7 in IF7. So on this basis, aluminium fluoride ion is known, but BF6, this ion is not known, but BF4 is known because the covalency of boron is 4. Next concept is your Sugen linkage, singlet linkage. So what he assumed? He assumed that atoms cannot have more than 8 electrons in its autonomous shell. He said he was very strictly to this rule. He was following the octet. He said that atoms cannot have more than 8 electrons in its autonomous shell. So according to him, octet rule is never violated. But it in certain molecules like atoms are linked not only by covalent bond but also by the other type of bonds, and this bond is called as the singlet linkage, which one electron is linked between the two atoms. Or such type of covalent bond is represented by the half headed arrow, means this is the half head, the tail and is half head or half bond. Or we can so it will like a dotted line arrow. So one bond, one is the dotted line. So in a molecule, number of singlet linkage is nothing but the number of all bonds minus number of bonds required to complete its octet. For example, if we take PCl5, so PCl5 number of singlet linkage is how much? So 5 is the valence electron, and 3 is the valency. So 5 minus 3, 2. So it will require the 2 singlet linkage. So 2 will be the single bond. You can see this is the Cl. So this Cl is one bond by the 2 electrons, but this will be only single electron. So this is represented by the singlet linkage. There is a 2 singlet linkage in PCl5. In sulfur, so valence electron is 6, okay, but valence is 2, so there will be 4 singlet linkage. So 4 fluorine having the half head arrows. You can say 1, 2, 3, 4. They having only single electron shared by the sulfur. So 4 singlet linkage and there are 2 normal covalent bond. In IF7, iodine having the 7 valence cell, but valence is 1. So there will be 6 singlet linkage. So 6 fluorine will be having the single shared electrons and one is the normal covalent bond. So all these are the concept of failure of the octet theory.